We're doing some greater rifts. I'm just kind of clearing our bags of everything. We got 1,413 imperial gems from the 40 plus puzzle ring vaults we did. It's just ridiculous. We'll put this in. I think they might be better. Put this in a general anywhere. We'll check these out. This has more. Poison damage. Yeah, this is gonna do more. I don't know if the cooldowns is better. See, I don't know if the 40% increase, 39% increase in impale will make it better. The stats on everything else are a little bit less. Guess the dex doesn't matter for it, huh? Assuming it has 10 damage. I'm not even sure how many rift keys I have. These guys were harsh. I don't have my happy bracers on. Sorry about that. Done this one before. If I go back around, I'll get like half a thing. Down I go. That's ridiculous.
You're not having very much luck finding a
Good amulet. Chop chop. I'm gonna go just a little bit down on there, so skill buff. Farewallers are super annoying. I keep noticing them, like they just stay on the stairs, they wall it in, run you out of hatred. No. Are you kidding me? I've never done that. Okay, that's not that bad. But I've never done that before. Can't even pick up the shrine. And we finished this rift. We're having a rough time. Yeah. come back here. Alrighty, I'm gonna take a short break. I'll be back in about 7 minutes. Thanks all for watching. We'll do some more riffs when I get back. All right, we are back. I think here. Let's see. There we are. Sorry that took so long. Normally we're a little bit faster than that. Probably should not be empowering these higher ones. I think I'm making some progress on how my CS life. It's full. It's wanting to trap me. Down. It's only working me on top of those things. Done 114. Always supposed to be 115. I'm too slow, too slow. Not enough room in this little room for a bunch of lightning like that. Ouch. Okay, this isn't happening. Double boss like this just seems to nail the time out of me. That's still one of them, right? Where was the shield from? I feel like every time I hit a mob, I need to just overshoot to see if there's a shrine. I That's interesting. I find it. I just noticed if I wiggle the mouse around a little as I'm shooting, just kind of back and forth, seems to way better control the mobs. I guess it works with the illusion just because the illusions don't need full hits, they just need to get hit. Hi, Ridge. Center of this. Kind of hilarious, he's outside. We're inside. Oh, nice. I didn't die. Guys are leveling so fast. three primal travelers. Excuse me. Hey Dawid, yes I do. Her name is Magic. She comes and chills with me sometimes while I play, and then likes to get up right in the middle of Greater Rifts. Welcome to the channel, Dawid. Where is this guy? Did we get one of them? Yes. Okay, that's what I can't find out. Alright. Isn't there a blue one in there? How are you doing today? What are you up to, Dawid? Learning the game? Nice. Welcome to Diablo 3. If you play Demon Hunter, I definitely recommend the Shadow Mantles build. Depending on what level you are, just have a high level person do a Nephilim rift with you, and you'll be level 70 in no time, and then you can get set pieces. And if you put together a Shadow Mantle set, it seems pretty strong. It'll get you like up to 80-90 quick, and then you can kind of specialize the pieces, and you can do higher rifts after. Oops, I'm not paying attention. My party had left. The party has left the building. I put out a set for it just a couple days, or a video just a couple days ago explaining the build I have. It goes through all the different skills and armor and kind of what you want on the different armor. It's not that hard to loot for sets. I mean, you can get probably within a day of doing like Nephilim rifts and Greater Rifts, you can find most of at least a set piece of each one, and then it's just getting better and better ones and hoping to get primals, which are basically items that are perfect rolls. We almost got this one. Have I even gone to get any shrines in this one? I forgot I was even wearing Nemesis bracers. There it is. Ah. Don't click on it. I thought he was going to click on it. It used to be really, really hard, but legendary pieces drop a lot more. Like, it's just there's a lot of them, so go sort of spending time getting them, getting the ones you want takes time. But in the beginning, it's pretty easy, and if you do the seasonal as well. If you complete all the quests in the seasonal game, it gives you a full set piece for whichever champion you're playing. But if you're just doing rifts and stuff, you'll be able to find okay pieces. You might find one or two good pieces of a set piece, and it just takes time to get better and better ones. And people have played the game enough to have done like mathematical calculations and figured out kind of what sets are the best or what combinations are the best, and they've proved it by getting on the leaderboards and getting higher than anybody else. And so while it's kind of fun to make your own set and, discover the game for itself, I found that when I did that, I kind of hit walls, in the aspect that the other ones, I'd see other people playing stuff and just flying by me. You can re-roll the set. You can re-roll one attri like one of the like if there's four or five different things, you can re-roll one of them. So you don't get to re-roll then every single skill, just one. How much time do we finish with? Also, when you get to level 70, your cube, you can like there's different. If you click on this, there's just different recipes. Like you can extract a power, and then that's how I get this. Like these are all items I've extracted the power from, and so then I can use Dawn's thing to recuse. And basically, you can choose three different ones of these, but it gives you kind of like an extra bonus where if you wanted it on your character, but you couldn't get it on. What are they saying? Three? Yeah, until you get an ancient one, you re-roll, or you can do re-rolls, With the cube as well, like one of the recipes is Reforged Legendary. And so if you have the mats, you can re-roll it and you can get another one just like it, but with different stats, and you keep on doing it until you get a better one. Oftentimes when you extract the power, because sometimes there's a percentage, like say my sword here, it has a 328% chance to, or increase damage by 328. That can go up to 370, I believe. 375, but if I use that in my cube, it would be at 375. It would be the maximum. I don't think the ancient versions, I don't think the special powers are, they don't get bigger, but they might have a greater chance to be higher, but they have the same limit. But the normal stats, like the dexterity usually is bumped up with an ancient item, but say on my elusive ring here, the critical hit and the critical hit chance would both be the same. But you can also, if you see under the critical hit chance, there's the Kaldesan's Despair. That you do that by getting legendary gems and leveling them up during greater rifts, and then you imbue them to an item that you have. So it's, I don't know, there's quite a few layers. In the video I did a couple days ago, I tried to explain everything, but it probably doesn't have quite everything, but it's got a lot of information that people helped me with. So you would extract items, the powers from items, because you want them in your set. Like, say if I didn't have the elusive ring here, which gives me 60% reduced damage after I vault. If I didn't have that, then I would come here and I would choose elusive ring. And use that instead of the Convention of Elements, which is offensive, but I need the damage reduction or I'll die. Yeah, I check every legendary. By the point where all these items that have red rims here are primals. So by the time you get to all primal items that have like perfect stat rolls, you're not going to be needing to check like a legendary one, because it's not going to be better. I have seen very few items where like it was, like say this is a regular and it's 99 crit damage and 10% hit chance. This is about as good of a roll as you can get. I still haven't found an ancient amulet or a primal one that's better than it. But everything else that I have is ancient or better. And I'm usually, if you just have one set, it's kind of easy to just go through. But when you have a few different builds, I found that since I started doing a couple different builds, it's become harder. It takes a little bit longer. Otherwise, I'm afraid I'm going to break down something I want. I don't want this to be my last game. It's like up on a rock. Are you kidding me? Tide just trying to get her head on it. I find you fine enough. I mean, for say if you're building the Shadow Mantle set, basically you need 5 out of the 6 Shadow Mantle pieces, because with the season you can be missing a piece of a set and still get the bonus for it. But so you have 13 items, and so 5 of the items are going to be your set piece. For your amulet and ring, you're going to need the Traveler's Pledge and the Compass Rose. And then your other ring is usually going to be Elusive Ring or Convention of Elements. And whichever one you don't have, you're going to be using the cube to get its power. And then for the... I'll have to look and see what the belt name is again. But for the bracers, it's the strong arm bracers. And I think that's... What am I missing? The bow is... It's not a bow. It's Carly's point is the dagger, and then the quiver is the holy point shot. So it's once you know what the pieces look like and you're like looking through what you got, you're gonna know what those items look like, and you're gonna be like, oh boy, I got a new one of this. Is it gonna be better? And then you have to wait to identify it and find out if it's better. One tip also is if you hit enter instead of moving the mouse to hit destroy when you're breaking stuff down, if you hit enter after you click on the item, it's so much faster clearing your bags. I was very happy when I figured that out. It's simple, but I don't think anywhere explained it to me. But it was intuitive from other programs. It all takes a little bit of time. When you first get to the end, it feels like there's a ton of stuff to do, and there is a ton of stuff to do. But eventually it kind of all makes sense how it fits together. You'll do some Nephilim runs to get some greater rift keys, and then you do some greater rift keys, you get some gems, you get to upgrade the gems. And then if you want to do bounties, it basically gives you stuff so that you can remove the augments and you can upgrade the gems, or I'm sorry, reroll items. Because to reroll the items, the legendary items, you have to do bounties to get the different materials. So that's kind of why I just enjoy doing Nephilim riffs and doing greater riffs, because you find the same stuff that you do doing the bounties, but you get a whole lot more experience doing greater riffs. You get a ton more experience. Like if you were, like if you just hit level 70 and you did a greater rift with me, I'd probably be able to get you up to like 300-400 within a couple games. But then I think after you get past about 600, I think it starts to slow down leveling. When you click on an item, when you're breaking stuff down in the at the armor, and you click on something to break it down, if you hit enter instead of going back to the middle of the screen to say destroy this, yes, I want to destroy this item permanently. If you hit enter, it does the same thing. Having fun here, I don't want to go. Yeah. One tip also about this set though is that it's really powerful and it kills, if you're not in a high level rift, it kills, whoops, it kills everything really quickly. And so it's really hard to keep your hatred. And basically, if you have no hatred, you can't attack. And so it's possible to do Nephilim rifts with it. I guess one thing that I was thinking about is just dumbing down the power. It's like if you're killing everything with one shot and you're not able to hit something a second time for hatred, just taking an item off or something. But once you have a full Shadow Mantle set put together, I'm pretty sure you should be able to run like 80, 85 by yourself. And then as you get it better and upgrade the gems, you'll be able to push 100. And then I'm just starting to push 115 with this one. I can do 114 and I can get about 30 seconds away from 115. I did 115 two-man with iRage here yesterday, and we were able to beat it. It took us a couple times, and I think the three of us here could beat 115 easy. Yeah, for the most part, you only attack the blues and whites. They're going to give you the most, they're going to finish the game the quickest, the most points. Like the little globes, it seems like it takes about 12 elites or rare mobs to clear a map. And it takes like quite a few monsters to get the same amount. It's just kind of when you're just a few percent away and you just need to finish it, do you kill the monsters? There are a couple monsters which they're like 1% or something like that, and they're just random. I feel like I need to learn better which ones are worth a just a little bit. I already died, we just need to get this done. I already didn't get my bonus. Where is this guy? I feel like I see him everywhere. Yeah, you can only destroy all with the white, the blue, and the yellow. with legendary, it's like, this is a legendary item. Are you sure you want to break it down? And it's like, 5 years ago, now, yes. It comes down to damage reduction, and pretty much all of the damage reduction that's on the person comes from the different items or the augmented stuff in the cube. And it basically, without the damage reduction, no matter what, how much Paragon, anything you have, you would just be dying. And so that's kind of where the interesting part comes in of balancing the different items. Like, you find this one, but you need this one, and so things get switched around in the cube, and we so could do 115 here. I don't have time to, I totally want to. I mean, for the most part, I have to keep on moving. The elusive ring, whenever I vault, where I jump across the screen, I can't be damaged while I'm doing it, and for 8 seconds after I vault, I have 60% damage reduction. Then I have another one, I think, where when my resources are above 90%, I get 60% damage reduction, and it all adds up. These all gonna fail. 3. Yay! Okay, I got one. Yeah, I got a new personal high for 3-man. I've personally never been this high before. I don't want to go. So like here, you click and the action will irreversibly destroy the item. You just hit enter, and that way it's like you can kind of just click through them. Legendary destroy. Legendary destroy. Doop doop. And then it's just about getting 100 of the item and being like, nope, that's not better. Nope, seen that one before, not better. Well, hey Dawid, I can't right now because I gotta go, but I'd be happy to power level you up, like to level 70, and then I can power level you up to like 200-400 Paragon or something in an hour. I'd be happy to do that. I can't do it right now. I'm hoping to be back on at 9 o'clock tonight, but I'm not positive I'm gonna be able to. It's not a scheduled time, but I'm trying to finish stuff up so that I can. You click a follow on here, it'll let you know when I'm live, and I'd be happy to power level you sometime. I can run a couple 9500, give you some drops I don't need that'll work for your set. I would do it right now. I gotta go. I gotta be somewhere in 5 minutes. I push this. But if you hit a follow on here, it'll let you know when I'm live, and I'd be more than happy to help you. Otherwise, just check on here and ask me anytime you see me. I ran somebody yesterday, I ran someone the day before. Thanks, Dawood, for the follow. And I'm happy to answer any other questions you have. I would keep answering them, but I gotta go. Okay, definitely. Yeah, if you see I'm on, just send a message. And super happy. Thanks everyone for watching. Thanks everyone for being here. Appreciate y'all. Have a great day. Sorry, I gotta run. I wanna play.